Hello, boring land. Gabe.
Nick.
And we're here today once again giving you another review
Another one.
for a movie that was requested quite a few times.
Especially after we did the trailer reaction.
And Nick.
Drishyam.
Drishyam. Oh man, I tell you what, I had so many thoughts about this movie. It infuriated me at times. We're going to talk about that. It infuriated me a lot of a few times. I thought it was very clever at
Oh
times.
yeah.
It's a mixed bag, man. This movie's a mixed bag. We're trying to not do as many spoilers because we realize as people are watching the movie and reading the comments, not everybody has seen them. So, like, oh, we'll take your opinion. We'll watch it. So we're gonna try to dance around a little bit, but we have to kind of give you the synopsis of what happens. You want to do that, or you want me to do it?
You do it.
So,
We just won't give anything that gets revealed, like say like the last 30, 45 minutes.
okay, so 30, 45
Because
minutes.
the other stuff, the big reveal, in my opinion, the big reveal, that happens in the first 30, 35 minutes, and the whole movie centered around how do we get around that,
Right,
so.
right. Okay, so here's what happens. And this is one of the things that infuriated me. But basically, we are introduced to our main character. It's played by the actor AJ.
He's played Vijay.
He's playing VJ, and he's in this town, people know who he is. He's got like a little cable business or something to that
And don't you
effect
love that he's just watching movies all
all
day
day long.
long?
I wish I could get paid to do that.
Love this
Favorite
character.
part though that he did there, took the phone off the hook. They can call me later. You know what I mean? Why
Oh
he's
yeah.
calling? Like, you, I wish I could do that.
He's trying to finish
I
this
take
thing.
my phone off the hook. Savannah's gonna drive over. Like, what are you doing?
Oh man.
Can you imagine, Jody? I'm watching a movie. Let me just take my phone off the hook. That's not gonna
You'll just be
happen.
able to feel in your senses. Oh, she's calling me.
But anyway, he right away they establish he doesn't get along with this one police officer that's in town who's a real lowlife. He's
I kept
strong
thinking of
arming
Gatorade when
people.
they said his name, Gatroid or something like that. I kept
Detroit,
thinking
yeah, I kept thinking
Gatorade.
Gatorade. That's how I
Didn't
kept
call him
reading
Gatorade.
it. We'll call him Gatorade. But the guy is a horrible police officer.
Dirty
But for the
cop.
most part, everybody knows who he is. In any event, they spent a lot of time in the beginning, which I'll have to get back to in a little bit, establishing that he's cheap. So he finally, his wife breaks him into sending his daughter away on a trip. Daughter goes away on a trip, and on the trip, there's this, basically affluent kids go on this
Sam, right?
trip.
What's his name?
The kid was Sam. He's being a creeper. He's like recording all these girls with his phone at the trip or whatever, and they tell the wing counselor or whatever. In any event, and I mean, they do it like in a series of flashbacks. You just know that daughter comes back crying. And you find out later on it's because Sam recorded a video of her while she was showering or whatnot and threatened to show it to her, or show or to spread it out and send it out if she didn't. And he says, "Please me" is what he said. So okay, either give me what I want or I'm gonna show this video. That's what it.
Complete creep.
Complete creep. In any event, mom actually gets involved, and this little guy has this phone, and he's got the video on the phone. They try to get the phone from him. One thing leads to another. They end up killing him.
Well, he's doing this with it, and the girl at one point is behind with a lead pipe.
Right.
He's like a bat, basically. She just wants to hit it as he's trying to preposition or proposition
His
the
mom,
mom
yeah, another creeper. Like, well, if your daughter won't do it, you'll do it for this
as a
video.
dad, as a husband.
Oh,
Take him out, lady. He's
oh,
done.
he's done. He's done.
And so he goes like she goes to swing right now, then he moves it so she stops, and he holds it right here, and she swings again, and he moves it again, and boom, hits him clear in the head, and I mean she got him good. Home
She had him
run.
good. That ended up killing him.
She
So
played for the Padres.
he played for the Padres. So then what happens is they're, they are trying actually to call our main character Vijay, but he's of course at his job watching movies, so the phone's off the hook when it
They made it
happens.
seem like his job was kind of a far distance, then.
Yeah, they kind of made it seem like it was a far distance. In any event, they try to settle this mess on their own. She basically tells mom, "No, we can't even call the police because this kid, surprise, surprise, first twist, this creep is the only son of the head like captain from the police force of the entire area."
Played
So
by Taboom, the girl we've seen in a few movies so far. She's
exactly,
awesome.
she was awesome in this movie as well. So anyway, the whole movie revolves around now the last place this kid was seen, or his car was seen, right next to their residence. And mom is a police captain. She's trying to find out where her son is. And I empathize with her because if I was a parent, I'd be freaking out too. Where's my child? And they're trying to catch this guy who they think is uneducated because he's dropped out, a fourth grade dropout, and he outsmarts everybody, all based on all the movies.
Based on the movies he saw. Based on I love that they were not afraid to go there and say he's got all his moves from movies. Wait, I know exactly what they're gonna do because I saw this movie. I just love that.
I love that part. So that part was awesome. But in any event. We go through the movie, and it's pretty much a battle of wits, and you can see how he set everything up, and like I said, those things were clever.
Yes.
But at the end, and we're not going to give a whole spoiler, he basically outsmarts the police, but, you know, we kind of get a little bit of closure as to what happens to Sam. Now, that's a pretty good, I mean, I try to give you...
Can't go further, yes.
Yeah. Now, your thoughts.
So I really, really love this movie because I love mystery movies. And this is a mystery movie that's not really a mystery movie because they – I thought for sure when you had Sam go into the room with the mom and the daughter, I thought for sure, okay, something's going to happen and we're not going to know until the end of the movie because that's what every other movie is.
Right.
But no, they just show you right away and it's all about the cover-up. And I love, and this is a remake from a movie from 2013, which I think was a remake for another movie, Drishyam, from before that. So this has been done a few times.
Okay.
And I'm curious if it's basically the same thing each time. But I loved the cover up, not because I'm all about covering things up, but because it was very, very clever, like you said. He put all the pieces in place. They made it seem like they were going to a different place to see this, this guy's sermon or whatever, and they were going to make a weekend out of it. And he had receipts, and he had ticket stubs, and he made a point to talk to every single person who owned whatever business or hotel so that when the cops would question him, they said, oh, yeah, well, was it this date or that date? What was that date? And then they find out it's because he kept telling them. Remember when I came here on Friday?
Right, even though
it was really Sunday. And so that was – all that stuff was awesome. And it definitely builds the tension inside. The suspense is there. And I absolutely loved it. There's obviously mistakes that he made, like with the whole car situation and Gatorade sees, and he's definitely convinced these cops are not afraid to get what they want by any means necessary.
Police and again, like you brutality. Said,
in this situation, I don't blame it. And you get a little, again, this is where it's a good film. They give you a little bit of that in the beginning where they're trying to question something else in Taboo's character. She just tells her deputies, get the information. Don't stop until you get it.
Listen.
Hardcore interrogation.
That is LAPD training at its finest.
Oh, snap. I didn't say it.
I'm just saying. Come on, guys.
You must be talking about a movie. But anyways, I really liked this movie. I really did. I thought it was very interesting. I thought it was very, very clever. And even though it's a movie, I didn't feel like too many of the things that happened were way above and beyond unbelievable. I mean, it was definitely... hard to watch at times, like when they get the family and they're doing the whole family interrogation.
That was tough. Yes.
I mean, talk about resiliency. But the father knew exactly what they needed to do.
Right.
He had a family who was on board pretty much the whole entire time.
Right.
And even when one family member wasn't at the very end, it's not really her fault. You can't blame her.
Right.
I really liked it. And then I love, like, we're not going to talk about it, but the end scene with the police building. I love that reveal.
Right.
I did not see that coming, even though they lay the foundation pretty thick at the beginning.
Yes.
I did not see that coming. I absolutely loved it. And talking about a film standpoint, I loved how the director shot the current and the one in construction back and forth to show exactly where he was at.
That was a pretty cool scene.
Loved it.
So let me go back a little bit to a couple of things you said.
Go back.
Okay, first of all, I'm going to talk about what I hated about this movie.
Ooh.
I hated Sam. Okay, he is a little
I think you're squirt. Supposed to hate him.
My daughter right now, who's 13, would have laid him out with no pipe, period, because he was a scrawny little dude. And it's daughter and mom? I guarantee you, my wife would not. What? You want me to do what? Listen, that kid would have had a problem walking out of that room, and it wouldn't even have taken
that pipe. And you guys can let us know in the comments. I think culturally... it's very strongly embedded that you respect any man that enters your home.
A man that does that?
I'm just saying. I'm not saying that that's absolutely correct, right. But let us know.
Okay, and that could be one thing. Another thing that really bothered me was, okay, the daughter obviously knew he was the son of the head captain of this entire area.
Did she know that, okay. though?
Yeah, she did. She knew it.
Sam, but did she know it was the chief's son?
Yeah, because she says, Mom, this is so-and-so's son. She says it. Mom didn't know. She knew it. So why would you not report it? Why wouldn't you? Do you know the scandal with the chief's son is doing this? Like, there's so many different ways.
Who are you going to report it to? The chief?
Yes, your
who's
son.
Gonna,
your
who's going to put it under wraps?
Well, I mean, or is she afraid of the scandal? Your son took a picture of me while I
was... Now, remember, their plan was not to kill him.
No, their plan was not to kill him. It ended up happening accidentally.
They were in a situation where they were basically defenseless against this guy.
My point was, they could have handled it so many different ways. They could have gone to the chief and said, hey, you know what? Your son did this because he came in the afternoon to tell him, and he didn't show back up till midnight or something to that, because he told her, you know, be alone at 11 o'clock, I think it was. You had all this time. You could have called the police department. I need to speak to the chief. It's pertaining to his son. Your son took an illegal video of me, and even if so, if he sends it, the way technology is today, somebody will be able to figure out that he sent that video. That's a bigger blight on the chief and on her department and on her family. Like, I didn't understand why mom, not to say I would want a video of my daughter getting out, that would be so heartbreaking, but it was almost like it was detrimental to them to where they did something wrong. She did nothing wrong. But this creeper just video with her while she was taking a shower.
But I had no problem. Obviously, I had a problem with that. I had no problem with the way they showed that the daughter and the mom were basically not making the best decisions. And they are worried about the repercussions and will almost do whatever it takes to not let you post that. Because I feel culturally and society-wise, and it's not just in India, it's a lot of places, the boy is favored over the girl. Right, I mean, think about way long ago in China where they're throwing the baby daughters, right, you know, over the cliff.
Right.
Like, it's not a son, let's get rid of it.
Right.
I mean, a lot of that still exists. And so when you got this son, who's the golden boy, the chief's son, his dad's this big-time business guy, and you have this girl whose dad is a fourth-grade dropout.
Okay.
And the scandal gets out there. You know, even in today's society, when a girl is reporting that a guy did something that they should not have done in the workplace, how much of that goes badly for the girl who was the victim? And so it's going to be her fault that she allowed herself to get videotaped. How could she be in a situation that she got videotaped?
Okay, you made a good argument there. Then the last thing that absolutely drove me crazy, you don't have to watch a movie. You don't have to be a police officer. You don't even have to be a fourth grade, a dropout as he was. Why bury the body in the house? Are you kidding me? I can tell you right now, 99.9% of people know if there's a body, don't bury it in the house, okay? In the yard, in the front yard, in the lemon tree, they're gonna find
the
it.
Lemon tree.
I don't know, some kind of tree. They're gonna find
ain't
it.
Ain't okay? No lemon tree no more.
There's a smell that comes from dead body. What are you doing? That was the dumbest thing that they, and like I said, that's the biggest issue I had with them. I get it. They were scared. They were panicked. They couldn't get a hold of him because he's watching movies and the phone was off the hook. But you had to know better than to bury this kid in the front yard. That was what drove me crazy. Now, obviously,
we both have seen the end, so don't freak out if you've seen the whole movie.
Right.
Non-spoiler.
Now, what I did love about the movie is how smart he was. And like you said, I didn't have any problem believing, hey, he saw this on TV, so he knew that was going to happen. One of the first things, I watch a show called First 48 all the time. And the reason it's First 48 is because normally police officers and detectives want to do all their interviews within the first 48 hours because that's when people's memories are fresh. Because after that, your memory starts to, you know, mess with you and you can easily forget details, which is why he went back and reinforced, remember, you saw me on the 4th. They remember they saw him, but they don't know what day it was. And the way he set those things up was fabulous. So I absolutely believe that. And he knew about all these things. They were going to check. Everybody knows they're going to check the phone. What's the first thing they do? They GPS you on the phone. So that was smart what he did with the phone. Those things I absolutely loved. And from that point on, the movie was fabulous. But from Sam before, I was so angry.
Now, I have a rebuttal for the burying thing. First of all, you probably didn't see a movie about how to properly bury, right? That was next week's schedule on TV. But also, as a story plot point, as a movie plot point, it's not conceivable that a character is going to think of everything correctly. And if the movie has that, it's just not believable. Now, this is a way different movie in 50 Shades of Grey, but I'd never seen it, never watched it. But what I heard the biggest complaint with people reading the books and watching movies is that Christian Grey, the main guy, he is perfect at everything. And that's just not believable.
Right.
So the fact that he would make a mistake makes sense. And B, the fact that it allows suspense later on in the movie. So that might be why they went that route. You're right. Who would think of that first? I mean, at least find a river or something.
Exactly.
case in point, when he gets rid of the car, that was good because that wasn't the best laid out plan. It eventually got found out later on.
Right.
But at least that was more of a rookie mistake. So I get your idea of
right.
your thing with the whole bearing, but I just don't think you saw a movie yet about how to properly bear.
All right. I'll take that one. But still, you know what I mean? Like, I guarantee you right now, my wife is in the same situation. The one thing she would not do, even if she could get a hold of me, is she would not bury them in the backyard. You know, we don't have a lemon tree. You know, and actually in Vegas, that would be hard because our ground out here is like caliche or whatever. Yeah. But still, you know, she wouldn't bury in the backyard. She would have figured something out, but she wouldn't have done that.
Just like when the pie is cooked and it's warming and cooling off and there's a piece missing. Before you tell your wife you did not eat it, make sure you wash your hands.
Oh, man.
Make sure you brush your teeth. You're not going to have pie on your beard and be like, I don't know who ate it.
It wasn't me. That's funny. But, I mean, other than that, like I said, I agree with you. After that, it was a great suspense movie. It was a great thriller. It kept you guessing. It was a great mystery movie.
Acting was fantastic.
The acting was
AJ
fantastic.
AJ did an amazing job.
And even the police officer, Gatorade, we're going to call him Gatorade, I hated him, but he did a great job making me hate him.
Yes,
he did a great job making me hate him.
It was really interesting. I didn't see it coming, the conversation on the hillside on near the cliff at the end with the chief and Vijay. Not going to go into details what the conversation is. I thought that was an interesting way to bring closure to right. their side of it. I thought it was an interesting way what happened ultimately with the chief. I did not see that coming, and so that was interesting. I mean, she was so determined, so that was great. I really liked a lot of parts of this movie. One big complaint I had as I was watching it was I was looking at Vijay's wife. I'm like, man, she's really beautiful. She's really young looking. Right. She doesn't look more than 10 years older than the daughter.
Right.
And I'm like, why did they cast someone so young looking when, no offense, AJ, but I mean, you're a little older than she is.
Right.
But then they clear that up later on in the movie when you right. find out about the daughter and her origins. And I won't get into that. And so the few issues I had, they cleared up
they
in
cleared
this
it
movie.
Up for you. Right.
It was going to be explained later on, which is basically them saying, just hold on, Nick. You're going to get the answers later on. And those are small nitpicky thing. I absolutely loved it. 100%. I'm ready to give it a grade.
All right. Well, I'll go first. For me, I love the thriller part to this movie. I did. I love the mystery part. And I think it was very, very smart. But still, there had to be like a real sense of danger. And for me, and I guess maybe like you said, I can't make that distinction between the cultural aspect of it, but I thought that guy was a little twerp. I can guarantee you that guy comes to my house and tries to pull that on my wife and my daughter, he ain't walking out of there. I mean, he's gonna walk out of there alive, but it's gonna be like, they're not gonna go to that extreme. So for me, he wasn't believable. So for that fact alone and the dumb decisions they make early on, I gotta give it a B. That was bad casting. They should have picked like some big burly guy that was actually intimidating where, okay, I got this video. Okay, we can't take him. But that little twerp, what was it? $1.20? $1.10 maybe?
Soaking wet.
Soaking wet.
All right, so you gave it a B.
Gotta go with a B.
My grade, it's flip-flop.
Sam,
flip-flop from our last review. I'm giving this an A, a solid A, 100%. I love this movie. I thought when we reacted to the trailer, I thought, you know, this actually might be pretty good. I love mystery movies. I really do. Murder on the Orient Express that came out a few years ago. I actually really liked that. I had never seen the original, so I didn't know what was coming at the end. A lot of people hated on it. I really liked it because of the mystery part. So I'm giving it a solid A for the reasons I've already talked about. I really don't have any issues in this movie. It had great acting. It had great direction. It had clever wittiness. It had twerps in there that made you want to hate them. It had answers to my dumb little plot point questions I had, or plot issue questions I had. So, I mean, for me, easily an A. And we thank I think it was Shawnee, our Patreon, that requested this originally. So thank you for that. So many others also requested it. So thank you for those requests. When we see a movie requested several times, then it's definitely on our radar. So thanks for the wonderful viewing experience of watching Drishyam. And thank you, Netflix, for having it on there.
I know, right? I know. you know, mostly we can find most stuff either on Netflix or Amazon.
But a lot of stuff we can't find now that we're getting down to it.
Oh, I still want to see Strike, Yuri Strike. Yeah. And, dude, you can't even buy... When you can't buy that thing on Apple, you got to be kidding me. Because Apple, you know, they sell everything, all right?
There was one comment that said, give us your address and we'll send you DVDs. I'm not ready to do that yet, but we appreciate the offer. Maybe we'll figure out a P.O. box.
A P.O. box or something. Yeah, that'll work.
But until, you know, Until our next review, please keep checking out our videos, keep liking and subscribing, especially on this one. Let us know in the comments how you feel about this movie. We get a lot of requests in the comments, but please also let us know how you feel about this movie in the comments. We love reading that. And as always, until next time.
It was the 4th, right? You remember I was here on the 4th?
Oh, yeah, it was the 4th. Yeah, he was here on the 4th.
It was the 4th.